Good morning and thanks for this invitation. Pretty tough to be the first in the morning, actually of the second day, but I hope I'm going to be capable of grabbing a little bit of your attention. First of all, a precision. You have seen on the screen and on the brochures the Wärtsilä High, and there has been no description what it's all about. And the reason is that is something that when we decided to present, it was not announced yet. It has been announced in the Nor-Shipping, at the Nor-Shipping, so at the beginning of June, if I remember correctly. But it's pretty much a pleasure to introduce you to this audience, maybe not a quantity audience, but I hope a quality audience. So grab your coffee and let's see if the topic would fit your interest. So we'll start, well, first of all, if this works. Because if it doesn't, Oh, yes, it does. So first, what's the whole idea behind? Well, when we started this development a couple of years ago, we looked at ourselves and said, okay, what's special? Where does stands the next technological developments that we could bring further? Does it fit in only one technology? So should we develop the same product going on and on and on and on? And the answer is yes, we should develop the single products. But actually, the major capability, the major leap that we could take is related to integrating different products, so to fusing technologies. And here, I present to you the first result of that. There is actually the traditional business that Wärtsilä is known about, so it's engine or power production, with a relatively new business that we enter in. Well, actually, we were there since several years, but we took a big steps in that about 3 years ago, acquiring an ENA, so an electrical and automation company. So that's the whole idea behind. And the result of that is the Wärtsilä High. So the first hybrid power module, and should be intended as a product. And in order to do my best in grabbing your attention, I use the oldest way I know, a video.
A revolution is about to happen in the marine industry.
Now we need the
technology has reached a level that needs a drastic change of mindset to move to the next level. Synergies, customers, those are the key words for us. That's why we developed the Wärtsilä HY, the first state-of-the-art hybrid power module in the marine industry. It will combine engines, energy storage system, and power electronics. The new integrated energy management system is the core element, the brain. Innovative features are embedded in Wärtsilä HY, such as the start and stop, the instant load taking, the power boost, the peak shaving, the cold system startup, and the green mode, which can achieve zero emissions. In all operating modes and load points, the operation is smokeless. Wärtsilä HY is designed in different versions for different ship types and optimized for every single application. It will cut down the operating costs substantially thanks to the lower fuel consumption and reduced maintenance costs. Wärtsilä HY marks a new milestone in the maritime industry. There is going to be a revolution, and we are leading it. Wärtsilä HY, intelligent power generation.
Okay, there will be a lot to talk about, a lot of details to talk about, but in 20 minutes, and especially from this stage, it could be a little bit difficult. But I will touch upon the major characteristic of this new introduction, or what we believe it will be the next technological step in innovation. Well, first of all, as you heard from the video, is it a different typology of product? Is actually the first time a technology company based like mine, like Wärtsilä, decide to take a step in dedicating a version of a product for each specific segment, so for each specific application. And in fact, what we launched in Norway at the Nor-Shipping, it were the two first versions of the Wärtsilä High or HY. One dedicated to the tug market, the one you see at least schematically on the left, and one dedicated to ferry passenger vessel, even small cruise ships. But what's inside the box? Let's have a look to that. Well, that's basically the combination, as I was trying to introduce you in the beginning, of the two major technologies that we have a strong position in. So one is the power generation, that is the traditional engine that you know, or at least outside it looks like that, and the power distribution and storage, or energy, sorry, distribution and storage. The combination of these two worlds, and actually the engineering of these two worlds based on the fact that they will be installed together, So not a retrofit project, not single component choice and then optimization, but based on the fact that these two words, these two products or product families will be installed together, we had the chance to engineer each of them in a way to try to take out the best. And you saw a few of the features in the video before. The other interesting perspective is that it's extremely modularized or modularizable. It means that it comes not only in one specific version, the one you saw on the previous screen. I would call it is the what we call mechanical hybrid. That is the first version that you see there on the left. But it's also a traditional diesel electric installation on the top right here, and a mix of them. So a mechanical hybrid with a shaft motor generator inline. Each of these single components can be selected in order to try to take out the best for a specific vessel typology. And that's what makes most likely the biggest step. That is tailored to each application, so to each vessel typology, and it's the first time where we have a product that it cannot be just shifted from one vessel to another. If you select the product for the tug, it is not the same product that goes on a container vessel or on a small tanker. It is actually tailor-made for the specific application. So I present to you here one of the installations that actually we had the chance to bring forward to announce during Nor Shipping, and a few of the values that it brings along. For a tug, I would start from example from the idea of boiler pool. You can see here down on the left. The idea of boiler pool, the concept of boiler pool, or actually maximum boiler pool, is shifted. The introduction of, the time perspective, or how long would you need that boiler pool, is one of the factors that brings the major benefits to this typology of installation. Or another thing, the operational cost, clearly space and weight, excuse me, so different perspective on how you design your vessel, as well as environmental aspects. No smoke during any type of operation, thanks to a new patent pending that we developed for this product, both when at the startup or during the normal operation of a tug. We announced a new design, actually cooperation, the result of a cooperation with a design study with the Pastorovich design, specialized in small cruises, so luxury cruises, or yachts. You see the result here, I can give you more information about that, but I believe it could be the most interesting to see the functionalities through another video, or at least the basic functionalities. Yes? Okay, this video was intended to show you the major functionality of the components, the single components, but it's fairly difficult on a video or on a 20-minute presentation to show or to try to pass the idea of the engineering that it stands behind. So what we were proud to announce at the same Nor Shipping when we announced this product, it was also the first contract for the same product for a tug owner, again. So we launched the version that is dedicated to tug, and it was a tug owner who contracted. It was a rimorchiatore riunite. It's about 75-80 tons boiler pool tug, harbor tug, and it will be operated, when in force, will be operated in the Mediterranean area. Great. And then I said, is it interesting to speak about the target Donso shipping meet? Well, most likely, yes. Is it? Well, more or less. OK. Then I decided to try to see, OK, what is looking like if I would have to apply this same concept, same typology of product to a small chemical and oil tanker, 16,000 deadweight tons, that I believe some people, at least in the audience, could identify themselves with. So typical vessel, and then I selected a route. Not really meaningful or special route, but the intention was to utilize a route that, again, could be something that some of the people could identify themselves with. So it's about 11 hours route, several different sailing modes, so the maneuvering, both thrusters and slow speed, service speed, slow steaming, and maneuvering again on the opposite side, and try to see, okay, which are the benefits that this product could take or could bring to a typology of vessel like that. Well, the smoke is still an issue, and this product, I can tell you, thanks to, again, a new way of utilizing different products, so a new engineer that stays behind, can guarantee zero smoke. The other interesting aspect is the possibility of sailing without any noise or without any pollution coming from the stack, coming into the harbor or out of the harbor. For example, 30 minutes before arriving to the harbor, you will start the green mode, and it's the same when going back. 30 minutes or 60 minutes, well, that depends on the module, on how would you decide the module you would like to utilize. The engine room will look different. We will try to undermine the basic principles of the ship design that are telling that usually you take a power prediction, then you add 15% engine margin, you add 15% C margin, and you get and you need to try to define your engine room in that way. Well, that's not valid anymore. That's the way you try or you will intend to utilize the vessel. We define the product or the engine room, the propulsion system you will select. As well, the green mode I already spoke about, and clearly increased safety. You will have a different source of power and therefore of safety on board, as well as for sure reduce OPEX thanks to load optimization, fuel consumption reduction, and peak shaving mode.
I just had a question. The previous hybrid, what's the difference between this one and Wärtsilä's HY or HY?
Well, yeah, correctly. We had or we witnessed hybrid installations back in the past. I believe we started in 2011 adding batteries to the, even before, adding batteries to the marine industry or to different vessels. Actually, Wärtsilä in Norway was one of the pioneers in that. This is a different level. This is a different engineering level. Before we selected single components, we added an automation. We tried to take out the best of these components, right? Good components trying to take out the best. Here, we engineer in advance the single components in order to change the performance as basic. You know, an engine, in reality, if you select it normally, it doesn't know if behind it there's a propeller or I'm making it easy, or a generator set, if it's an auxiliary engine or a main engine. In this case, we pre-engineered the single components, including the engine, knowing that they will be supported or helped by different energy sources. And that's the major difference.
All right. Thank you. You try to make it simple for me, but still it's not very simple for me. But I hope that you understood. Anyway, thank you so much for coming. Mr. Giulio Tirelli, Director at Marine Engineering at Wärtsilä HY. Thank you so much. Thank you.